Hey guys, welcome back to In Your Face Horror. Today, I would like to do a deep dive into a creepy urban legend from our home, good old Wisconsin. Known mostly for serial killers and cheese, Wisconsin is brimming with creepy stories and legends from across the state. If you enjoy these single story, more in-depth episodes, be sure to leave a like. And if you'd like to see more like this, comment below any other creepy stories you think we should cover. As one of my personal favorites, the story of the Beast of Bray Road proves to be an interesting and slightly unnerving story. What's really roaming in the Wisconsin backwoods? Bigfoot? Bears, or a wolfman. All speculation centers around a handful of strange occurrences that will leave you intrigued and slightly unnerved. Sightings of the Wisconsin werewolf started as whispers in 1936 on a quiet rural road just east of Elkhorn, Wisconsin. Through the years, more stories have expanded throughout the southern part of the state and even into northern Illinois. A rise in sightings in the 1980s and early 90s led a local newspaper to assign one of their reporters to cover the bizarre story and possibly find an answer to what was stalking the backwoods. Though initially skeptical of the Bray Road monster, Linda Godfrey interviewed many witnesses and believed the accounts they shared, noting the sincerity of each story. Her articles have been collected into a single book on the subject called The Beast of Bray Road, Tailing Wisconsin's Werewolf. Two witnesses have claimed to have damage on their vehicles from a large dark creature they encountered driving along Bray Road late in the evening. Doris Gibson tells Inside Edition in a 1993 interview about her Halloween encounter with what she initially thought was an animal she hit with her car.
It was foggy out and I was a little bit afraid. And this big thing come just like trucking, you know? Just trucking down the road at me, man. I looked at it and I'm like, ah! And I ran, I got back in the car. You know, and before I peeled off, that thing scratched the back of the car.
Lorraine Andreese also had a strange encounter on Bray Road with what she could only describe as a werewolf.
It had really big claws. It was holding its roadkill like it had elbows. And it was kneeling on two knees, like a human being might do.
After the initial story came out in 1991, it prompted more witnesses to come forward with their stories, some dating back to the 1970s, everything from a man passing through the town who saw a similar creature, knowing nothing of the tales that ran through Elkhorn, to chickens disappearing from a farmhouse just off of Bray Road. The beast has been described as a large, bear-sized creature with pointed ears, covered in black fur, able to run on all fours or upright. Some accounts recall thinking it was a giant coyote until it stood up on its hind legs. It has been seen feasting on prey at the edge of cornfields in the dead of night. To this day, there are still no pictures or video recordings of the creature, but that hasn't stopped the werewolf mania from grabbing hold of the town of Elkhorn. You could buy t-shirts, coffee mugs, and even a local bakery that makes werewolf cookies. It seems like an easy myth to dismiss. It's probably a giant dog. It's probably a bear, a coyote. But what are the chances that so many people have encountered the same eerie giant creature only to be wrong? What do you guys think is roaming in the backwoods of Wisconsin? We'd love to know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for tuning in for this episode. We hope you enjoyed our content. If you want to see more just like this, be sure to subscribe to In Your Face Horror for new creepy content. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll hope to see you soon. And stay creepy. Don't use that last line. I mean, no. No, don't do that.